This case is about what happens when a presumption of guilt, when a gut feeling that you have the right suspects takes over from logical and objective evaluation of the evidence. This case is about what happens when you pursue individuals as opposed to pursuing the truth.
How many times does the evidence have to tell us it's not Sebastian and it's not Atif? We still don't know who committed these murders.
And the question that you're required to ask yourselves is, what has the state shown me to make me believe that he is guilty without having one reason to doubt it?